Beitou was the ancestral homeland of the Ke-Dagalan people, one of the Taiwanese aborigines. They occupied the hilly terrain before the Chinese settlers gathered here 4 centuries ago. This immigration leads to Beitou having its name as Batao, 8 vote or 8 part. In the year 1946, Taipei government was established. In 1967, as Taipei was upgraded into a metropolis, Beitou District together with Dahu and Shiling Regional were included in the administration of Taipei City. With the booming of hot springs, Beitou have one of the largest concentrations of hot springs and spas in the world. This resulted in the formation and fusion of different racial backgrounds. Rules implemented to develop the district of Beitou forces the public to embrace modernization. Skies, now blocked by the towering residential apartments, multi-story shopping complexes and office buildings, show the gaps for more spaces in this modern era, causing every available space a money-making opportunity. Modern buildings unfold themselves into a new height, overshadowing the past buildings which once bear the radiating masonry finishes. While Xing Beitou aims to achieve a modern height, this particular market also strives to survive within the revolution. Beitou Xing Sijie is one of the few culturally preserved streets that maintain the traditional culture and identity of the street itself. Colorful market umbrellas lighten up the dull overshadowing city streets, attracting visitors to the hidden lane. These umbrellas then create another space for other sellers to conduct their business, whereas the permanent shop-lock buildings around there are the government's property. Reminiscence of an alley is felt when walking through this space where the layers of structures starting from the market umbrella, the masonry finished buildings to the colossal modern buildings show the change of architectural language within the street. Cramped walkway created by the extension of stalls on the sidewalk, making the flow of circulation congested, squeezing through the sea of people, especially during the weekends. Before dawn, all freshly harvested goods are transported into the street and the street will be flooded with people by the time the sun rises up. Motorcycle is the main transportation in this area and the number increases as the market starts unfolding its business. The smell of freshly plucked fruits and vegetables, chunks of meat that dangles with its smooth glowing textures, the sweet taste of local delicacies, shouts from the vendors providing discounts, and the warm touch of the local smiles embrace the visitor's senses, recalling back the days before the skies were towered with skyscrapers. This street, famous for its fresh good and unique Taiwanese delicacies, has always been the local source of goods since the 18th century, maintaining the original culture till the present modern environment.
These streets
The aromatic Taiwanese delicacy fill the sense of smell and charm the soul towards what the hot boiling pots have to offer. This savory and mouth-watering Taiwanese cuisine are the next main center of attention in this historical marketplace. The variety of food choices changes to suit the changing season, to complement the taste buds and to sustain the quality of food. In Beitou Xing Sijie, there is a separation between the indoor and outdoor market. The outdoor market is the original style of business where a small space in the middle of the road is sufficient enough to set up a business. However, in the indoor market, a small workspace is rented or bought to start a business. An example of the indoor market would be the Beitou Shichang. This two-story, fully air-conditioned market is divided into two parts, where the first floor is reserved for grocery, while the second floor is for the butchery. Since 1979, licensing is required to sell any goods to the public in Taiwan. It is also common in any other countries, but there are still a few who sell their goods without a license in the outdoor market. Therefore, during a police patrol, most of the vendors in the outdoor market will try to flee. The friendly locals warmly welcome any visitors to look at their splendid products. Besides passionately promoting their products, the locals are enthusiastic in sharing each step involved in the process of making.
竹子小的时候刚长出来芽，台湾纯种的原生种的竹。你知道吗？你们去马来西亚应该知道，龟崎群岛，英文叫乌鸡。
Heartwarming smiles of the locals will absolutely welcome the visitors back to their humble stalls, and these are the great memories that will last throughout the lifetime. Never will be forgotten. After a day-long work, the liveliness of the marketplace has slowly toned down and everything is packed to embrace the new day. The sight of the utensils being washed dry, tables being scrubbed, and the remaining unsold goods being kept for the following days represent the trademark of the locals' daily routine. A clean and fresh new morning awaits the locals, making this 8th Street shine brighter than the overshadowing towers. Nevertheless, this historical site has preserved its original identity since it was started in the 1900s. Despite the vast development of the surrounding environment that constantly changed to fit the spirit of this modern age, Beitou Xing Sijie will always treasure as the marketplace that preserved the smile and working spirit of the vendors.